Aloha, true believers. Joel Pal, Spider-Man. Good morning, Cadre. We're going to continue with the Oz shaving test. This time I'm going to do the new base and the old base together, one on each side. To save time, I've already pre-lathered them in my brushes. So this side is going to be the current base. I do need to add some water to them. I haven't completely finished lathering them. I just got them lathered into the brushes. Be a little bit trickier. Only doing this on one side. And then the new test base on this side. So I'm doing this just so I can get a good side-by-side comparison to see if I notice any differences. So yesterday I used the new base by itself. It had been a few days since I'd used the current base, so I wanted to kind of do this. I thought I'd noticed like a different feeling with the lather. It feels a little bit different, I guess. Side by side, maybe I don't feel as much as I thought I'd did yesterday. Slickness and glide seem about the same. That's just kind of what I thought yesterday. Residual slickness about the same. Yesterday was a holiday, so I had the whole day to do whatever I wanted. This time my Air Force brother didn't want to come out with me, so I did a couple things that I knew he wouldn't want to do. Since I have a vehicle and the Air Force guys don't, usually I'm the one driving them around. So I went to the beach that I've been wanting to go to, and surf is a little high, but still okay for a little bit of snorkeling. And the bottom wasn't as good as I was expecting it to be. It's still just, like, most of the shores here are just rocky. They're not really what you expect when you think of a coral reef. They're just rocks with a little bit of coral growing on them, but not like the beautiful corals that you see in pictures and stuff. But I did see two sea turtles. And actually got a couple pictures with both of them in frame. And then I went to a hike up an old crater. And it's following a, the trail follows up an old like rail car with train tracks straight up the mountain, like straight up it. It's a 1,000 feet climb in like 0.9 miles. So it's pretty steep, especially right at the end. So far, not really noticing any difference between them. So that was a pretty grueling hike. Took me about a half an hour to get up. It was probably about half that getting down because I didn't have to stop for breaks on the way down. But spent probably an hour up top just relaxing and taking in the sights. It kind of reminded me of my college days, hiking up mountains and then just hanging out at the top, looking at the scenery. Definitely not the highest peak on the island, but you definitely feel like you're up there when you're up there, so to speak. A pretty good view of the ocean, pretty good view of Waikiki Beach. You can see a bunch of the places that I've been snorkeling. And then while I was up there, I could see one of the bays that we went snorkeling the first time, and the conditions weren't really great when we went there, and it looked like they were a little better today or yesterday, so I decided when I was done hiking to go check that one out again, and it was a little better. I stayed on the deeper side of the bay and snorkeling was a little better, visibility was better. I think I saw a few more fish than last time, but definitely got lots of good pictures of fish. One thing that I've struggled in the past is to get pictures of parrotfish, which are like one of my favorite fish to see underwater. They're so colorful. Blues and greens and pinks, and in that bay they've got parrotfish that are like 2 feet long. They're enormous, the biggest parrotfish I've ever seen, and because the bay gets a lot of people swimming in it and it's secluded, the fish aren't as timid around people as they are in other places. So really you can get right up to them and they don't swim away. Well, they swim away, but they don't like dart off super fast. And so you're able to get pictures of stuff a lot better in that bay. And I was finally able to get some good pictures of parrotfish. So if you're watching this and you want to see all the pictures that I took, just go to theshavencadre.com. And look for my thread. It's called Spider's Hawaiian Vacation, and I've got all the pictures. from all three of those places in that thread. Today after work, I'm probably gonna go to Pearl Harbor. Try to see some of the stuff that I didn't see last time. Namely the Battleship Arizona, or the Battleship Missouri. I saw the Arizona last time. Actually, the Arizona's closed. I guess they need to do some repairs on the memorial or the something. So it's closed until like March. So you can take the ferry out to the memorial and they'll do a drive-by, so to speak. But you can't get off onto the memorial right now, not until March, I think. So I'm glad I already did that once. I'd say the only difference between the two is Poche feel, and it's slight. I don't know. To be determined, I guess, if there's a, after the dry down, if there's something I feel later that, makes a bigger difference, but right now it's very slight difference. We're gonna finish up with some bay rum for some witch hazel. And if you notice, my Hawaiian shirt today looks a little familiar. It's gonna have the exact same one in purple. But this is my first time wearing the blue one. All right, so side by side, really couldn't tell any difference. I'll contact Ian, let him know what I thought about him. See if he can tell me what he put differently in the new formula. I'm just guessing he put an extra oil or some butter in there. It definitely changed the consistency of the soap. But shave wise, I really didn't notice any difference, in it at all. Just maybe a little bit difference in the post-shave feel, but, that's about all. Still really good. Just like you expect from Isle Shaving, and yeah, had a great shave. So mahalo for watching, and we'll see you guys on the forums. Bye.